As you said, Norman, their plan was a pretty simple one. Build those pump stations to pump the floodwaters into the Mississippi River behind me instead of Lake Pontchartrain. Washington, though, didn't see it that way. So Louisiana's congressional delegation and the nonprofit group set up to push this plan are defeated for now, but they are certainly not giving up hope.
Going forward, we just have to demand the best solutions for this area because the consequences are too great.
Lisa Ludwig is the executive director of the nonprofit Pump to the River. Like many others, she doesn't know yet why Pump to the River sank in Washington. She says there is rock-solid state and local support, and it would benefit more than 100,000 people in 26 neighborhoods in Jefferson and Orleans parishes.
And at St. Dominic's, just a couple of months ago, the Corps even admitted that this was the best option to pump to the river. They were the best projects, but the option one is cheaper. So, yeah, but we just don't feel like we can settle for cheap. It's too important.
In a statement today, Congressman Steve Scalise said, quote, "It's time for this administration and congressional leadership to put their money where their mouth is and support flood protection." Senator Mary Landrieu said the decision to drop our Pump to the River amendment is unconscionable. Jefferson Parish City Councilman Tom Capella agreed.
In this country that just spent or printed $1 trillion for corporate giveaways, and we're looking at a system that has two parishes, two of the largest in the state. You're talking about hundreds of thousands of residents, tens of thousands of homes and businesses. To not do this right is unacceptable.
Today, the problem's still here, and so we continue to fight for it.
Both Lisa Ludwig and Tom Capella told me that they hope that this is attached to other legislation at some point soon, but Capella admitted tonight that is not likely. Live on your side along the river, Scott Walker, WDSU News.